Pracho. Where are Swarup Damodar and Rupa Goswami? Where is Sanatan? Where is Raghunath Das, the savior of the fallen?
Ode Swarup Damodar, wo Rupa Goswami joy la loi, Sanatan joy la loi, Dolokji and Dick Tengau Ze, Raghunath Das joy la loi.
Where are my Raghunath Bhatta and Gopal Bhatta? And where is Krishnadas Kaviraj? Where did Lord Gauranga, the great dancer, suddenly go?
Odik Raghunath Bhatta, wo Gopal Bhatta joy la loi, Krishnadas Kaviraj joy la loi, Ju Gauranga, Chui Fan de Mo Ze, Tuk Yin Hui Liu la loi.
I will smash my head against the rock and enter into the fire. When will I find Lord Gauranga, the reservoir of all wonderful qualities? Being unable to obtain the association of Lord Gauranga, accompanied by all of these devotees, in whose association he performed his pastimes, Narottama Das simply weeps.
無法得到在所有這些奉獻者的陪伴下從事娛樂活動的主Gauranga的聯誼 Narottama Das 只有不停地哭泣
So today being the disappearance day of Srila Gaura Kishodas Babaji Maharaj will speak something
今天是Srila
Gaura Kishodas Babaji的引職日 我們會講一些關於他的消息的事
Pranam Mantra offered to Srila Gaura Kishodas Babaji 我們看回這個Pranam Mantra給Babaji的Mantra
Namo Gaura Kishodaya Sakshat Vairagya Murtaye Vipralamba Rasambode Padambudaye Te Namaha I offer my respectful obeisances unto Gaura Kishodas Babaji Maharaj, the spiritual master of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, who is renunciation personified. he is always merged in a feeling of separation and intense love for Krishna. So, Srila Gaurakishodas Babaji Maharaj is described as being almost illiterate. In a material sense, anyway, he had not had an opportunity for much education. But we should not think that he did not understand the philosophy of Krishna consciousness. As described in Pranam Mantra, he is in the feeling of separation from Krishna. And the personification of renunciation. So, Vairagya, this renunciation from the material world, and transcendental knowledge, they are bestowed on a person who has pure love for Krishna.
咁一個人咧，如果擁對擁有對Krishna純粹嘅愛咧，佢就會得到啦呢一個Vimyaya啦，即係棄絕啦，同埋咧對主嘅愛。
Wherever there is actual devotion to the Lord, then there will naturally follow renunciation and transcendental knowledge.
咁如果一個人係對主有充滿愛嘅話咧，好自然咧就會係變得棄絕啦，同埋都充滿咗呢個超然嘅知識。
So Srila Gaurakishodas Babaji Maharaj had renounced the material world quite early in his life. And he had taken the renunciation of Babaji. Babaji, sorry. Transcendental to the material ashrams. Brahmacharis and grihastas and vanaprastas and sannyasis are the ashrams of the material
world.
But Babaji renunciation, the dress of the Babaji are for those persons who have transcended all aspects of material life. And we see the dress of the Babaji in the photograph which we have of the Goswamis of Vrindavan.
咁就好似咧，係即係Babaji佢哋著嘅衣服啦，同埋咧呢六個Goswami哥斯華為佢哋嘅衣着嘅打扮都係咁樣。
The Goswamis, of course, are not dressed in saffron; they're dressed in white.
咁我哋咧就唔係著橙色 saffron 嘅顏色嘅衫啦，而係著白色嘅。
So we would often say that, you know, white is actually the color of the Paramahamsa.
咁咧，我哋成日都話咧，白色咧就係呢一個Paramahamsa，即係嗰啲最高階、最超然嘅奉獻者，佢哋嘅衣着，佢哋嘅就係白色嘅。It's
a very, very exalted level.
咁係最傑出嘅、最高嘅呢一個嘅位置。
So you can see the Goswamis in their Babaji dress. They have the very dhoti, which only goes down to the knees. And simply they have one pot which they will have for their to carry water and So Babaji's mode is to completely absorb themselves in the bhajan, in the worship of Krishna.
咁咧，巴巴豬佢哋嘅心水咧就完全咧沉醉咗咧喺呢一個Krishna嘅崇拜呢個嘅讚歌嗰度。
There's Gostavanandi and Bhajanandi. There are two processes to practice devotion.
咁喺我哋嘅奉愛嘅服務入邊咧，有兩個收集嘅方法。
Gostavanandi are those who go out and preach.
咁有一個方法咧，就我哋出去咧就傳教。
And Bhajanandi are those who simply sit and practice on their own.
咁另外一種咧，就係佢哋就好簡單坐低，就自己喺度收集。
So just like the Goswamis were living in Vrindavan, particularly Raghunath had set Mina's ashram, made his bhajan kutir in Radhakund.
咁就好似六個Goswami啦，Goswami啦，佢哋咧就喺面丹佢咧就收集啦，就好似Raghunath Goswami啦，佢咧就喺Radhakund度咧就有個 bhajan kutir， 即係佢專係我哋念誦嘅一個嘅小屋。
So today you can see also there's a lot of Babaji's there in Radhakund.
咁而家咧去到Radhakund咧，你都會見到咧好多呢啲Babaji's喺度嘅。
So after the departure of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there were a good number of Babaji's. There were many people following the type of renunciation just as practiced by these Goswamis.
咁當主宰人隱職之後咧，咁其實有好多一啲Babaji's，佢哋就跟隨住好似Goswami佢哋嘅收集一樣咧，就係喺利用呢個方法去收集。
And Gorkishodas Babaji made his residence somewhere around Mayapur, Navadvip.
咁而Gorkishodas Babaji 咧，佢咧就係佢嘅居所咧就係喺Mayapur、Navadvip附近。
Not any one particular place, some moving different places.
咁我以佢冇特別一個居所，佢就會喺附近嘅地方咧，就即係喺度唔同嘅地方度居住。
Generally, Babaji's like to stay away from the world.
咁一般嚟講咧，Babaji咧都係會即係唔中意同呢個世界一齊嘅。
And we have to chant many rounds every day, usually at least 64 rounds.
咁你每日咧都會念誦好多嘅圈數啦，一般嚟講咧最少64圈。
64 rounds means 1 lakh holy names, means 100,000 holy names.
咁64圈咧就即係話係100,000次聖名。
And in fact, you see Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Prabhupada had told the members of the Gaudiya Math that if they didn't chant 64 rounds a day, they were considered patita, fallen.
咁而Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Maharaj都講過咧，就係如果係同高啲阿媽嘅收集者講啦，如果你一日你係冇念64圈咧，你咧就係咧被視為咧係低墮墮落嘅。
And so members of the Gaudiya Math, their main business was chanting the holy name.
咁所以高啲阿媽高啲阿修院嘅收集者咧，佢主要嘅工作咧，佢哋嘅靈修咧就係念誦。
At the same time, they were also required to go for preaching.
咁但係同一時間咧，佢都需要咧出去傳教。
So you can read about that. Of course, it's described in the Bhaktisiddhanta Vilasa, in the book written by Bhaktivedanta Swami.
咁喺Bhaktisiddhanta Vilasa 嗰本書入邊咧，你就可以讀到咧呢一啲嘅思慮時光。
So within our own society, there was an incident one time. One time, Srila Prabhupada awarded Babaji to a devotee.
Srila Prabhupada addressed?
Srila Prabhupada awarded Babaji initiation.
咁咧就喺伊斯蘭嘅歷史入邊咧，亦都有一個事跡，司徒時光嘅就係聖卡巴巴咧，就將誒賜咗呢個Babaji嘅呢個身份咧，就俾一個奉獻者。
What happened was, there was a young man in America who was, he had been told by doctors that he had some disease And he didn't have long to live.
咁咧就係嗰件事情咧，就係喺美國有個奉獻者啦。咁但係醫生話俾佢聽咧，佢咧又得到絕症，咁剩翻即係可以生即係生存日子咧，好少。
Okay, so this young man had been told he didn't have long to live, so he was going preaching.
咁因為呢個後生仔，佢就醫生話俾佢聽，佢冇乜日子無多啦，於是佢就走去傳教。
And they would arrange college programs, and he would talk to people how he is preparing for death.
咁佢就會有好多大學嘅呢一啲嘅節目啦，就佢就話俾啲學生聽咧，佢點樣去準備迎接呢個死亡。
So he's a young American man, and it's quite an interesting topic, and people naturally would want to hear.
咁因為佢一個即係後年輕嘅美國人啦，咁所以啲人咧就好有興趣咧，想聽呢一佢講呢一樣嘢。
So it happened that he came to Mayapur with all the devotees, and at that time we had many young American devotees. So it was brought to Srila Prabhupada's attention about this young man's preaching. And they suggested to Prabhupada that Prabhupada, why don't you give him sannyas?
咁跟住咧，啲奉獻者就建議，即係向小巴巴建議，點解你可以俾托缽章呢個稱號俾呢個後生仔喎？But
Srila Prabhupada said, well, this is not a reason to take sannyas.
咁小巴巴就呢個唔係去接受成為托缽章嘅一個原因。
He's going to die. If he's got some disease, he's going to die. It's not a reason to take sannyas.
佢雖然佢有病啦，就係死啦，但呢個唔係咧，佢出家成為托缽章嘅原因。
What it can do is we can give him Babaji initiation.
咁我哋可以做嘢，我哋咧俾呢一個 Babaji 嘅啟迪俾佢。
And Babaji, they simply chant the holy name.
咁因為 Babaji 咧，其實就好簡單，佢就淨係念誦呢個姓名。
And study the books of the Goswami.
同埋咧係即係閱讀咧係哥斯華米布斯方面嘅呢啲佢所寫嘅書籍。
He can stay here in Mayapur.
佢都係留喺Mayapur。
No, you're going to leave the body.
因為佢即係就係離開身體啦。
You don't need to go around preaching till you drop.
咁你唔需要咧，即係去傳教，去即係去傳教傳到你死嗰日。
Sit down in a holy place.
咁你就坐喺呢一個聖地嗰度。
And chant the holy name.
就係專注念誦聖名。
Just like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he went to Jagannath Puri for his final years.
咁就好似Bhaktivinoda Thakur, 佢就喺佢最後嘅日子嘅時候咧，佢就去到 Jagannath Puri 嗰度。
Of course, some people they like to leave the body preaching.
咁當然咧，有啲人咧係中意咧，即係會傳教傳到去離開身體嗰一日。
Somehow Krishna Goswami was saying to Srila Prabhupada, we will take you back to America. And he told Srila Prabhupada, he said, just like Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, that die on the battlefield. Die on the battlefield is a glorious death for Kshatriya.
咁咧對一個世界嚟講咧，人在戰死沙場咧，其實係一個光榮嚟嘅。咁聖帕巴喺佢嘅所寫嘅書入邊嘅要旨咧，講到有兩種好光榮嘅死亡。咁第一個咧就喺薩瑪迪當中咧，係離開呢個世界。
咁另一種咧就係當你去傳教傳揚呢個Krishna之覺嘅時候咧，係離開身體。 particular case, Srila Prabhupada encouraged that, let this man come and live here in Mayapur. He can be a Babaji, and he just has to chant the holy name.
咁跟住聖巴巴就話：啊，好似呢個後生仔咁咧，佢可以住喺Mayapur啦。就誒跟住咧就接受呢個Babaji嘅啟迪啦。就跟住咧就淨係念誒念誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒誒
Babaji's. They simply do bhajan. They sit and chant and they read the book.
咁 Babaji 咧，佢哋就淨係做 bhajan， 然後佢哋就坐喺度啦，讀書啦，同埋咧唸誦。
But generally they don't preach.
一般嚟講咧，佢哋咧就唔會去傳教嘅。
So it's like the level of Uttama Adhikara.
咁佢哋咧係呢個最高階嘅奉獻者嘅階層。
So Srila Gaura Kishore Das Babaji was living in Navadvip.
咁 Gaura Kishore Das Babaji 就住喺呢個 Navadvip 嘅呢一度。
And he would go sometimes to the home, to the residence of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
咁有時咧，佢就會去到咧係 Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 嘅屋企嗰度。
And he would go there, and you can see if you go to Bhaktivinoda Thakur's house, you can see there's a bhajan kutir place for Gaura Kishore Das
Babaji. 如果大家係去到Bhaktivinoda Thakur嘅屋企咧，你會而家咧都會見到，其實有一間係念誦嘅小屋咧，就係屬於咧係 Gaura Kishore Das Babaji 嘅。Srila
Gaura Kishore Das Babaji would go there to hear Srimad Bhagavatam from Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
咁 Gaura Kishore Das Babaji 咧就會去到呢一度咧，就係聆聽咧係 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 佢所講嘅聖典 Bhagavatam 嘅課。
So although he was illiterate, Gaura Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj still had a great taste for hearing.
咁雖然咧佢係一個文盲啦，唔識字嘅，但係咧佢對聆聽呢個經典咧係有一個好高嘅品味。
And he did not discriminate. He did not think, oh, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he's a householder. What does he know? But he understood Bhaktivinoda Thakur was a very elevated soul.
咁我咧就唔會睇唔起Bhaktivinoda Thakur， 因為佢一個居士啦，佢都知道咧Bhaktivinoda Thakur 佢對呢一個經典嘅認識咧係非常之深嘅。So
he would like to go there to his home.
咁所以咧，佢好中意咧去到Bhaktivinoda Thakur 嘅屋企。
So it came time that Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, he was told by his father Bhaktivinoda Thakur that you have to take initiation.
咁跟住咧就Bhaktivinoda Thakur 就同 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 佢仔講咧，你咧要接受啟迪啦。
So Bhaktivinoda Thakur explained, I'm your seminal father, I cannot give you spiritual initiation.
咁Bhaktivinoda Thakur 就同Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 解釋咧就係我係你嘅生父啦，我就唔可以俾你呢個靈性嘅啟迪。
You have to take initiation from somebody else.
你咧要由其他人靈性老師嗰度咧接受呢個啟迪。
But who to take from?
咁但係由邊個嗰度去接受呢個啟迪咧？
Because there were so many degraded, so many corrupted, petty persons in the form of gurus and spiritual leaders.
因為咧當時咧有好多咧係非常之腐敗咧，好貪腐嘅呢一個所謂嘅靈性導師或者靈性嘅領袖。
There's nobody qualified.
根本咧冇人咧有呢個資格。
But Bhaktivinoda Thakur said no. There is one person.
咁但係咧，Bhaktivinoda Thakur 就同佢仔講咧，就唔係嘅，有一個人咧係有呢個資格。
This Gaura Kishore Das Babaji.
咁咧就係 Gaura Kishore Das Babaji.
He is a qualified.
佢係一個咧絕對有資格嘅人。
You should take initiation from him.
你咧要由佢嗰度咧接受呢個啟迪。
However, this is a big adjustment. There's a big difference between these two people.
咁但係咧，其實佢兩個人咧係其實有好大嘅分別嘅。
Remember, I said Gaura Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was seemingly illiterate.
咁頭先都講過啦，Gaura Das Babaji 咧係差唔多咧係唔識字嘅文盲。
And Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was the most educated, scholarly person.
咁而Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati 咧就係一個咧係受過好高深教育啦，係一個學者。
He had been educated fully by his father Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
佢咧由佢父親嗰度咧係接受呢個咁高深嘅呢個教育。
And he had written Surya Siddhanta, which gave him the opportunity. He was asked to become the professor at the Calcutta University.
咁佢都寫咗《Surya Siddhanta》 呢本書啦，令到佢咧係呢個加爾各答大學咧邀請佢咧做呢個教授。
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was writing so many articles. He was learned in several languages. He was so well read in all the scriptures. And he's told, you have to take initiation from this man. And this man is not educated. And he doesn't have any disciples. He never gave initiation before. And he doesn't have any money. And he doesn't have any society or temples. He's a Babaji. He's living, he eats his food out of the skull. He dresses in whatever torn cloth he can find. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur told his son that he is a qualified
person.
So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati took a humble mood and approached Gaurakishore Babaji and asked him for initiation. But Gaurakishore Babaji said, no, how could I ever give a person like you initiation? You're from such a high class devotional family. You're so educated. I'm nothing compared to you. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati went back to his father. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur told him that you have to get initiation. If you don't get initiation, then your life is useless. So then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati went back to Gaurakishore Das Babaji
Maharaj.
And he pleaded and pleaded. Please, please give me shelter, please accept me. So then Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, well, I will have to ask Krishna. Let me ask Lord Krishna, see what he says. So that was left like that for some time. And after some time, then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati came back and said, well, have you asked Krishna yet? What was the reply? And he said, no, I haven't asked him yet. He didn't reply yet. So then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati became very serious and he said, then my life is useless. Then I'm going to commit suicide. I'm going to give up my life. So then Gaurakishore Das Babaji reconsidered and said, alright, then don't waste your life.
於是呢,
So he was initiated. The name he is given is given there in the Pranam Mantras to Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati.
而這個名字就是在Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati的統文裡面是用寫的。The
second mantra, Shri Varshavanavi Devi Daitaya Kripadaye Krishna Sambana Vigyana Daini Prabhavenama. So the name is Varshavanavi Devi Daitaya Dasa. Sounds like something from Jayapatakamara. So, yeah. Varshavanavi Devi Daitaya Dasa means one who is favored by Srimati Radharani.
咁係有呢個名嘅意思咧，就係咧話一個咧係Srimati Radharani好鍾愛嘅人。所以Gorkishore Dasbabaji was not initiated by Bhakti Vinod Thakur.
But when it came to put the different acharyas on the disciple of succession, it was Gorkishore Das Babaji was put there. Because he initiated Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati. And he was regularly coming and hearing from Bhaktivinoda Thakur, so he was taking shiksha from
Bhaktivinoda. So
this shows us that shiksha is the basis of the disciple of succession. In a similar way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was a shiksha disciple of Jagannath Das Babaji.
So Jagannath Das Babaji also Bhaktivinoda Thakur's
So another important pastime in relation to Gorkishore Das Babaji came with the disappearance of Gorkishore Das Babaji.
而另外一個很重要的消息光就是Gorkishore Das Babaji的隱跡的消息光。Before
Gorkishore Das Babaji left the world, he requested those people who were serving him that I want my body to be dragged through the streets of Navadvipa.
咁就當Babaji隱跡之前咧，佢就同咧係服務佢嘅人講啦。當我離開咗身體之後咧，我就想我嘅身體咧，就係你哋拖住我嘅身體咧，就係喺呢一個Navadvipa嘅街上面咧行。So
after he left the body, there was some discussion, some dispute about what should happen to his body.
咁所以當Babaji離開咗身體之後咧，就有啲爭論啊，就應該點樣咧係處理佢嘅身體。
Now because he was such an elevated personality, some unscrupulous persons had the desire to have his samadhi in a particular place where they could make money.
咁咧就係因為佢一個咁高階嘅奉獻者啦，咁所以有啲咧立心不良嘅人咧，就係想咧就即係幫佢咧建一個墓場，咁咧就係喺嗰啲地方咧，等呢啲人咧可以賺錢。Just
like every year when you go to Mayapur Navadvipa, we go to visit the samadhis of these great acharyas.
咁就好似我哋每年去到Mayapur Navadvipa，我哋就會去到咧呢一啲靈性導師嘅墓場嗰度咧，係去朝聖。And
it's customary to give donations.
咁就即係我哋有個習慣，就係都會咧俾一啲捐款。So
naturally, some people wanted to have the body of Gorkishore Das Babaji, and they would make a samadhi for him, and they will collect money.
咁所以有啲人咧就所以就好想咧係即係可以攞到Babaji嘅身，即係佢嘅遺體啦，然之後就幫佢整咗墓場啦，跟住佢就可以賺錢。
It will be a good business.
咁呢個係一盤好嘅生意。
But they wanted also to drag his body through Navadvipa.
咁啊，但係都想咧，就係拖住佢嘅身體咧，就喺Navadvipa嘅地方咧，就係去唔同嘅地方。
So at that time, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada came, and he said, "I am the only disciple of Guru Kishore."
咁跟住喺呢個時候咧，Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj 就出現啦，佢就同呢啲人講：我係Babaji唯一嘅門徒。
And they were saying, "You're not a Babaji. How can you do? You can't do anything."
咁跟住咧，但係呢啲人就同佢講，你都唔係一個Babaji，你根本咧，應該咧乜嘢都即係唔應該做。
So at that time, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati challenged them.
跟住咧，跟住Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj 就挑戰佢哋。
He said, "Who amongst you have not visited a prostitute in the last year?"
咁跟住佢問你哋咁多人當中，舊年有冇一個人咧係冇去揾過妓女嘅？
Who amongst you have not been irreligious in the last month?
你咧喺上一個月咧，任何一個人有冇做過啲咧係唔符合宗教原則嘅嘢
？Is there any one of you who have been free of, who is without sin?
你哋有冇一個人咧係冇任何嘅罪惡活動
？They all. Back the way, they all knew they were all sinful, degraded
people.
So Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati explained that this desire to have his body dragged through the streets of Navadvipa was just the humility of his spiritualness.
馬拉巴巴吉馬拉翠想佢嘅身體咧，係即係喺拉瑞嘅街道上面咧，係拖行咧。其實咧係一個好謙卑嘅一個嘅象徵。
It was not required to actually do that.
其實咧根本就唔需要實際上咧去做呢樣嘢。
So they put his Gorkishodas Das Babaji's body was put into samadhi.
咁所以咧就Babaji嘅遺體咧就放咗喺一個墓場嗰度。
Initially the samadhi was in Navadvipa, but then there was a flooding, and at that time there was some danger there, so the samadhi was moved to over to
Mayapur。咁本來咧個samadhi咧就係喺Navadvipa嘅，咁但係因為咧係擔心咧係行河泛濫，咁所以咧就最後咧就將呢個samadhi咧就移咗去Mayapur嗰度。Samadhi
is there at the near to the yoga peak there.
咁咧就係喺Yoga Peak嘅附近嘅地方。So
Srila Gorkishodas Babaji chose to disappear on this suspicious day, the last Ekadasi in the month of Kartik.
咁Gorkishodas Babaji去隱職日咧，就係喺呢個吉祥嘅卡奇月份嘅最後一個Ekadasi。
Just before the end of the Chaturmasi.
咁咧就係呢個 Chaturmasi 即四個齋戒月嘅最後嗰部分。
So we will do push panjali when?
Yeah. 咁我哋中午咧就會做一個獻花嘅儀式。
So I'm giving second initiation today to the devotee Yogita Radha.
咁咧今日咧就Yogita Radha Mataji就會接受第二次洗礼。
You can go and offer obeisances to Prabhupada.
咁就而家就邀請 Mataji 就去頂拜請翻阿爸。
So Yogita Mataji has been coming to the temple for many years.
咁Yogita Mataji 咧就其實嚟廟宇咧已經一段好長嘅時間。
Since in the times of Tamalkrishna Goswami.
咁當時咧係 Tamalkrishna Goswami 咧，仍然係。
Of course, she's from Hong Kong. She grew up here in Hong Kong.
咁佢哋喺香港長大嘅。
So her deities are well known because she puts pictures on Facebook every day.
咁大家都好熟悉佢嘅神像，因為佢都會將神像嘅相咧、漂亮嘅相咧等喺 Facebook 嗰度。She
has her own Radha Krishna deities.
咁佢有喺屋企係有呢個 Radha Krishna 嘅神像啦。
She worship Him very nicely. And of course, we have the deities here also on Janmashtami. So to worship deities, actually, one should be second initiation. So we're giving him the guide to
Mantra.
We hope the deities will go on to become more and more blissful. So ask all the devotees to bless her. Hare Krishna. Second initiation, of course, is not as important as the first initiation. Second initiation is, however, a part of the initiation process. As Prabhupada wrote in a letter to one devotee, that with the second initiation, it completes the process of initiation.
咁就聖花哥咧係誒，亦都寫咗封信俾一個奉獻者咧。佢就話誒，當你接受咗第二次啟迪咧，就係完成咗呢個啟迪嘅過程。
And one can do proper worship of the deities by being second initiated.
咁當你接受咗第二次啟迪咧，你就可以咧係好正式咁樣咧係做呢個神像崇拜。
To quote Jaipataka Swami Maharaj, he said, if you worship the deities without second initiation, it's something like playing with dolls. But it becomes proper than you're doing it and the proper standards when you're second initiation is also a responsibility for senior devotees. I mean, you're second initiated, you have to show the example to the younger devotees.
咁當你接咗第二次啟迪咧，亦都係成為一個比較資深嘅奉獻者咧，亦都要咧係樹立一個榜樣咧，係俾呢個比較年青嘅奉獻者。
Particularly in standards of cleanliness.
咁尤其是咧就係清潔嘅標準。
Spiritual practice.
同埋咧，我哋嘅靈修。
All of these things we should, Brahmana, second initiated devotees, they should be showing nice standards.
咁因為係一個婆羅門啦，咁所以咧。 就接受第二次啟迪嘅奉獻者咧，就要咧樹立呢一個嘅好好嘅榜樣啦，成為一個標準。
So we are happy to see Urvita take nice interest in our Krishna consciousness movement.
咁我哋咧好開心咧見到Mala姐咧係即係非常之有呢個熱誠啦，係喺呢個 Krishna 之國。
We need the Hong Kong people, the local people to take up this movement.
我哋咧需要啲本地人咧係去咧即係繼續呢個運動。
This movement is for everyone.
咁呢個運動咧係俾所有人嘅每一個人。
We have Chinese devotees, we have Indian devotees.
我哋有中國人啦，亦都有印度人。
Everyone is serving of Krishna.
咁每一個人咧都係喺度咧為 Krishna 服務。
Prabhupada would say, United Nations of the Spiritual World.
咁咧，聖巴巴形容呢個係一個靈性世界嘅聯合國。
Everyone, what we saw here this morning, Mangal Arti, we had a very nice gathering at Mangal Arti. There must have been about
15-20
devotees.
Mm-hmm.
A number of the Indian community all came, knowing that this is an auspicious day.
咁有好多印度嘅會眾都嚟咗啦，因為都知道咧今日一個好吉祥嘅日子。
So wonderful to see so many people here.
咁咧就見到咁多人喺度咧，就非常之真係太好啦。
Okay, thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada.
Krishna.